Want to learn how to dodge and burn Photoshop images the easy way? I'm going to show you how right now. So I've got an image here from Colorado. We were in an aspen grove and there was dappled sunlight coming in through the canopy onto the trail and onto the foliage. And the trail already makes a nice leading line through the image. But what I want to do is guide my viewer's eyes through the image by dodging and burning, creating those lighter and more saturated areas that our eyes are naturally drawn towards. Now, I could use some manual methods to dodge and burn, but there's a really easy tool, a plugin called Lumenzia. It only costs about 30 bucks, I think, and you can install this and basically create luminosity masks, which I'm going to show you in a second, which acts as kind of a stencil to help you help prevent you from drawing outside the lines when you're dodging and burning. Now, dodging is brightening areas of your image, and burning, just like if you were to burn a piece of wood, it makes it darker. So we're going to dodge and burn using Lumenzia. So the first thing I want to do is I like to start out with a little bit darker image to bring back the lighter areas when I dodge my images. So the first thing I'm going to do is start out with a brightness adjustment, and I'm going to bring that down about here. Looks good to me. I don't want to lose too much of what I have in the image already. And then I'll probably make a levels adjustment just to work with the contrast just a little before we start. So I'll darken it up even a little bit more by sliding this here. I don't want to lose too many of my shadow, too much of my shadow area. So I'll bring this, or actually I do want to make it a little bit darker. So probably right there is a good starting point for us. All right, so luminosity masks. The first thing I'm going to do is come up here. You have darks, mediums, and lights. So focusing on the lighter areas of the image, the places that in my image I want to accentuate, like this dappled sunlight, I'm going to start out with a lights one. And this is the lighter you see in the lighter areas you see in the image are what you're going to be drawing inside. So that stencil I was talking about, if I hit lights two, that's a little bit too dark for me. So I'm going to go back to lights one, and then I can use this levels global adjustment and hone in on exactly the areas that I want to focus on. So I'm looking at that, those areas of dappled sunlight, and that's pretty good right there. So I'll choose that, and then I will choose dodge for dodge and burn. And now I'm back in my image and I can start sampling from these areas. So if I come up here and sample this color, because what did I say? We're going to make the areas that we want to focus on a little bit brighter and a little bit more saturated. So I'm going to choose that color, and I've got my brush, and I'm just going to hold down Control Option on my Mac and increase that brush size a little bit, and then just start painting. And as you can see, it's already starting to brighten it up, and I'm not affecting the shadows of my image. I'm just affecting more the areas where you saw in the preview where we have the highlights that are already there, but now we're just bringing them out a little bit more. So it's really bright over here. I don't have to do too much work there. But these areas here, and you start to really see very quickly, especially if I turn this off and on, how much it's already added depth and perspective to our image. So that's pretty simple. The next thing I could do is come over here and sample. If I hold down Alt and sample my color of the trail and choose a lighter and a slightly more saturated color, then I can come over here and start hitting these areas of dappled sunlight on the trail. And again, now if I turn this off and on, you can see quite a bit of depth has been created by using Lumenzia to create luminosity masks for a sketch or for a a template basically for us to not fall outside of when we're dodging and burning. That's the easiest way that I know how to do this. So if this helped you, please subscribe to the channel, and I will show you the final product right here. And this is after doing a little bit more work, and it looks beautiful. So hope your images turn out to look just as good, if not better, than mine.